video, I'm going to show you how to set up a wire simulation using my hair system. And this is the model I got for this tutorial. And this part is where I want to apply the simulation. And before we get started, you should make sure that your mesh should have multiple segments in order to achieve more smooth curve and deformation. So first of all, in order to set up an hair simulation, we need a curve. And you could either make a curve manually using the curve tools, or we could select the edges we want from this base mesh and extract it using the tool under modify, convert, and polygon edges to curve. You can go to options menu and reset settings and just convert it. Now we got a curve here, and this is quite important to delete the history and center the pivot. And now we can move it to the center of the base mesh. Now we are ready to set up an hair simulation. So we can select the curve and go under an hair. You're gonna see make selected curves dynamic. You can go to options menu again and reset settings and apply it. So if we run the animation now, this is what you're gonna see. And now the next step is to attach this base object to this curve. And I'm gonna use wire deformer to do it. And now I'm gonna go back to modeling workspace and go on the deform menu and select wire deformer. You can reset settings for this one as well. Anyways, I can select the wire deformer, and first of all, it's gonna require a shape for the deformer. So I can select the shape I want and hit enter, and now then it requires a curve. And you should select the curve under hair system, one output curves, not the original curve we applied the end hair simulation. So after you select this curve, hit enter again. Now the deformer has been applied. So if you run the simulation again, it's working perfectly. Let me just expand the timeline. But as you notice, the both ends are not moving at all. That's because if you go to the follicle shape node, you're gonna see the point lock has been applied to both ends, and we can just change it to no attach and use constraints instead. So we can move this wire along with the objects attached on both sides. So let me just set up a constraint now. So if we just select the curve again, and let me just isolate it in the viewport for now. And we can go back to FX workspace, and let me just go to control vertex mode and select the vertex on the very end. And we can go to end constraint menu and add a transform constraint. And I'm gonna do the same thing on the other side. Great. now V show other objects again, and if you go to FX tool set, you're gonna see this play button, and it will allow you to move objects while you're playing the animation. So if I click this button and move this constraint, and other constraint is here as well, so now the constraint is working. So let me just go back a few steps. Now we can just parent these objects to this constraint object. So let me just select this this USB-C port object to this constraint. You can just press P for the parenting. And I'm gonna do the same thing to this group as well. Alright, so I'm gonna select the group here. So this should be in this group as well. So let me just see if everything is connected. Okay, now we can parent this to this other constraint. Let me just double check. Right, now if I run the animation again and move those constraints and see how it works. It's working fine. So now you can adjust some settings within the and hair shape node under the hair system. You can find all the settings here. For example, dynamic properties. You could increase stretch resistance to make it more solid. By the way, you will have to reset the position every time you run the simulation, otherwise it will just stay there. Or you could just keyframe the location of those constraints, so you won't have to undo the transformation all the time. So let's see what we got in the dynamic properties again. So here we got stretch resistance. I might increase it for this particular simulation. And you got compression resistance, and there are a lot of things you can play with. And another important fact is the mass and drag damp is quite important as well. So this is it for setting up a wire simulation in Maya using nHair system. So thank you for watching, and see you next time.